sharp and stylish, Starfleet uniforms were designed to be both functional and to put Starfleet's best foot forward when encountering alien species, while at the same time fostering a sense of unity among the officers and crews of Starfleet themselves. Hello and welcome to Trek Facts, a fun and fast informational video series on the fundamentals of Star Trek. In today's episode, part one, we're taking a look at Starfleet uniforms from 2151 to the late 2260s. Though the styles would change often throughout the various eras of Starfleet's galactic exploration, Starfleet uniforms would always attempt to be the most comfortable yet professional design Starfleet had to offer at any given time. During the 2150s, with Starfleet on the verge of breaking the Warp 5 barrier and beginning its program of exploration, uniforms were of a jumpsuit design. Containing many pockets for storage of various instrumentation, this design reflected a time in Starfleet history when, generally, multifunctional tools had yet to be developed, and thus required an officer to carry more technology around with them. In a dark blue design with a patch on the left arm just below the shoulder representing the starship or facility the officer came from, it was immediately clear that this design was during a more hands-on time in Starfleet history. Departments were denoted by colored stripes on both shoulders. Gold for command, red for operations, and blue for the sciences divisions. Flag officers, such as admirals, wore stripes of red and white. Rank pips were worn on the right front shoulder so that at a glance every crewman and officer would immediately know the rank of the person they were addressing. The uniforms were also made out of a flame-retardant material. To go along with this uniform, Starfleet officers would also be issued disposable undergarments in a bright blue color. These were boxer brief-style underwear and tank tops, both trimmed in black. During away missions, members of the away team could also wear a ball-type cap if the mission required it. This cap was embroidered with the specific registry number of whatever vessel the away team member hailed from. The flag officer's uniform was very similar to the standard uniform. The main difference, other than the red and white piping, was that of a dress undershirt with a necktie. This uniform also had red and white piping on both cuffs of both sleeves. For events that required a higher level of professionalism, such as diplomatic functions, a dress uniform was also created. Other uniform variants, including a desert style that was in beige tones with optional sunglasses, and for missions of a colder nature, a jacket heavily quilted was also available. And if an officer was required to enter an even colder environment, such as a Class M planet in a permanent state of winter, a heavier, thicker jacket could be worn. By the mid-2230s, the Starfleet uniform had become more streamlined. Retaining a dark blue color as its base, this uniform had a stylish jacket and matching pants. The shoulders on these uniforms contained piping with 5 stripes for males and 4 stripes for females. This piping would also be in the color of the specific division the officer or crew member that wore the uniform hailed from. Unlike the earlier Starfleet uniforms, these division colors were altered to be metallic tones. Command being gold, silver representing the science divisions, and copper that of operations. A uniform badge with rank pips was added to the left side of the chest. This badge would eventually be adopted as the standard badge and called the Starfleet Delta. There were also different variants of this badge, one for cadets with a rectangular border and 4 stripes under the Delta, and one for flag officers which held the Starfleet Delta encircled by a laurel of leaves. A special operations badge was also available in black. A medical variant was also created for crew members of that division. This uniform variant was completely white, a stark contrast to its blue counterpart. In 2257, however, Starfleet began testing a new style of uniform aboard their Constitution-class starships, the USS Enterprise being one of the first ships to implement this new uniform. Retaining the same jacket style, these new uniform jackets were completely division colored. Going back to earlier uniform division colors of yellow for command, red for operations, and blue for the sciences divisions. Like the previous uniforms of this era, this jacket could be paired with a matching skirt. The new uniform held a more friendly feel from its previous incarnations, representing a new era of exploration for Starfleet, and by the mid-2260s had once again been changed to a more informal look. And although various styles would be tested, a final version would be settled on by 2265. Retaining the same division colors, these uniforms would simply be a black undershirt with a division color overshirt and a pair of black pants with high-cut boots. A single-piece skirt style would also be implemented. The rank of the officer would now appear as braided solid and dotted bars on each sleeve cuff. Ensigns would have no bars, Lieutenant Junior Grade a dotted bar, Lieutenant a solid bar, Lieutenant Commander a solid bar and a dotted bar, Commander two solid bars, and Captain two solid bars separated by a dotted one. Starfleet would also temporarily go back to the idea of having separate symbols for each vessel and facility in the Federation. The original Starfleet Delta would be retained by the USS Enterprise. The only constant in these new patches would be the use of the department symbols on the badges from the previous uniform badge incarnation. There were various variants of this uniform as well. There was a green wraparound variant for the captain, as well as a medical tunic for the doctors and nurses, among others. Through the mid to the late 2200s, Starfleet would continue to frequently change and adapt its designs in an attempt to create the best garment to represent both Starfleet and its role in the Federation at large. Though it wouldn't be until the early 2280s when Starfleet would finally settle on a uniform that would balance both form with function and be both comfortable for the officer while maintaining a stylish professionalism that would continue well into the 24th century.